and flower buds, just from my brain. I have a 12 by 24 canvas and doing it the long way. So I thought it would be nice to just have some flowers going on today. Like I said, very intuitive. I'm not thinking about what kind of flowers. I'm not thinking about too much detail. Just something I saw on my walk. Simply outlined, just to give me a little bit of idea. Once you outline it, it becomes pretty much a, for me anyways, paint by numbers game. And so I've had my paints on my palette for a few days without using them because I've been busy with other things. And my challenge is going to be to use what I have left. And again, I'm not going to think too much about it. I'm just going to go right in. There's a lot of noise outside. I have my window open because I live by an elementary school, and when the kids reach fourth grade, they have what they call a moving on day. And since everyone's been so cooped up, they arrange a lot of car parades that go by. Beeping, screaming. They've also done that with the high school. And middle school, so it's been a constant kind of celebration, but it gets noisy. And the other day, the fire trucks just would not stop with their sirens in celebration. But the weird part about that is that it just evokes memories of accidents and things. So it's kind of funny to process it as a celebration. But kudos to the town parents and the parents for celebrating the kids in Corona times. Just a very loose style. Like I said, I don't think much about it. I have the visions in my brain I know will come out. And it's my interpretation of what lives in my head about these flowers, I guess. just a nice flowy flower. Kind of twigs and buds coming off. Like I said, I saw on my walk today, so. Actually, my walk yesterday, because I didn't walk today yet. But I saw these really bright, beautiful flowers. To get in the studio and paint them. So this is all from my memory. And again, if you hear some screaming outside, it is part of the town celebrating the school getting out for summer, I guess, in car parades. It's actually died down a little bit, which is good to be able to hear me. And I've been doing some commissions lately, so I haven't been on live. Welcome back if you're with me. I have to learn to talk louder in the videos, I think. But sometimes there are people in my house working on Zooms, so I can't be too loud. But if you have any questions, feel free to ask me. Whether they're questions about inventing or writing a book or painting, I can give you my experiences. And hopefully that would be helpful to you. I had this size canvas, a 24 by 12, so I envisioned this type of painting going vertically on it. Let's get some greens in there. My favorite color, although I have many, I must say, but one of my absolute favorite colors has always been green. There's so many greens in nature, and I just have always loved green. have some Native American music in the background today, which is very soothing. I usually don't have music because if I upload this to my YouTube channel, it goes against the, you know, the music licensing. So maybe I won't be able to have the music on YouTube, but you can enjoy it here if you can hear it. It's just a very light background. Soothing music. What's going on with everybody today? Are you working from home? I'm gonna grab a little bit of a narrower brush and go in with some lines for the twigs. That delicious paint. Delicious is the right word for this. It's like cake icing. Delicious. Okay. I'm going to get my palette knife down, one of my favorite instruments. some color for the background. Let's see what we're gonna go for. No preconceived notion of what I'm doing. Gonna mix up some bloom green. See where it goes. And some white. Let's see how this looks. Yes, I like that. I like that very much. I think that's why I mixed it. See, I think I already know a little bit what I want, but I don't overthink it, and I just change it if I don't like it on the canvas. But I do believe that whatever comes out is meant to be what's on this canvas, as well as I believe that this canvas ends up wherever it belongs, wherever it should live. So whether somebody buys it or I end up keeping it, although I do put most of them available to buy for ridiculously low starting bids on eBay so that it's accessible to everyone, and I'm kind of democratizing the snobby art world because I don't believe you need middlemen or middle people in many, many fields that for decades you needed people in the middle to give them a big cut, and that's the same in the inventing world. And I broke that all down in the steps you can do it yourself too. And that's a staunchy old profession. And I just said, you know what? I'm going to figure this out. Because I didn't have the money to pay people in the middle. And not only that, the people in the middle really don't have a crystal ball, and they can't do it any better than you if you have the passion behind your vision. So for some reason, the universe told me to get back into painting, and maybe it's just to help people figure out the process, to bring them enjoyment or meditation. I mean, it can be frustrating when you think that it has to be a certain way, and it doesn't. Paintings that look like photographs aren't all that artistic in my mind. I used to do more realistic paintings, but they took forever. Unnecessary. I like the freedom of this right now, at this stage of the game. And I think somebody could watch this and very easily pick it up. The minute you start worrying about it too much is when you lose the beauty of it. But that comes with time, because you do have to know a little bit about the composition you want, but not worry about it. I know that's confusing, but it takes a while to master that. With commission work, I have to be more conscious of They hire me for my style, but I have to be more conscious of what they want. And it's a little bit aggravating. A lot of artists don't like commissions because, I don't know, they feel like they're, kind of restricting what they need to do. Restrictive. But I like the challenge. Always up for that challenge. What do you think of the background? See, you can go in when you're doing the background, kind of cut in areas. That's really fun to do. It's sort of hard to talk while I paint, and I think that's a brain thing. I think the brain actually turns off part of the way you talk. But that's where all my meditation comes in. It's very meditative. I lose hours doing this. The other night, I started at around 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Next thing I knew, it was 11:30 at night. And I went to bed, and when I woke up, it felt like I had worked out, like had a gym workout the day before. And I went online and looked up standing. Is standing good exercise? Something like that I googled. And because my legs were hurting me. Not hurting, just felt like a workout. Stiff, sore. And I read that standing burns, I think it said between 100 and 200 calories per hour. So it was like I had a workout. This is laborious when you're standing and moving and thinking. But it's so meditative in the mind that I don't notice it. So I encourage people to try painting. If it frustrates you too much, you're thinking about it too much. Nothing has to look like a photograph. In fact, to me, the art is when you interpret things like this. It's not trying to paint a rose that looks like you could pick it. I mean, that's an art too. And if that's your forte. Good, that's fine. But all I'm saying is that you don't have to think that that's the only way to capture things or compare your artwork. And that's the good news. If you go to a museum, you see all kinds of artwork. Modern museums, and contrast that to like a portrait gallery, portrait museum. Lots of variety of styles, and who determines those are the ones that get into the museum? It's so subjective. So you can be the curator of your own museum. I give you permission. Color in the flowers. All right, I'm just going to finish this up. And this one will probably be on eBay if you're interested and you like it. The bids start at a ridiculous $1. And the bids are usually 10 days. I'm not sure if I'm going away though. I might go down to Cape Cod for a little bit. So in that case, my eBay store would have to be put on vacation mode for a while because I wouldn't be able to mail them out. But I'm not sure if that's going to happen. So sometimes I'll get in here with a brush, but I like when the palette knife picks up the edges of things and carries it into the background sometimes. Thanks for joining me. I think I'm going to maybe come back later with another live. Let me show you this a little bit closer. Nice, delicious, thick paint. Hopefully this brings you a little joy today, and I'll catch you later. Thanks again. Bye.